that this is one memory is there. Okay, so before interrupt, this is before interrupt. So what you are having some memory address. Memory address is starting from 0, 1, 2, like this it is going on. Okay, this is your say unconditional branch. Unconditional branch, here you are having some memory address, say 1120, some memory address. So here this is your main program. So whatever all these instructions are executed, but when you are getting the memory address, say 255, when you are having the memory address 255, during that time, let us assume that you are getting the interrupt. Means, let us assume that during that time, your this interrupt flip flop is set to 1. Now what will happen? So when interrupt is set, then program counter automatically it will set to say whatever this address is there. So this say from here it will again go back to this your this conditional, and here it is saying that unconditional branch, because here already interrupt is going on. So as you are having the interrupt at 255 location, your program counter will store the memory location 256. It is your incremented to 1. It is incremented to 1. So where you are having the interrupt, you are having interrupt at your 255 location, and your program counter it stores this address 256 next. Okay, and it will start executing it. So here it is going to initial, here it is telling unconditional branch, and it is telling one memory location, that is 1120. So from here, wherever this location is, from that it will jump to this location, the 1120 location, and it will start executing the instruction. Okay, this instruction will goes on till it becomes 1. Okay, again when it is set, now it is coming out of this program. Now it is coming out of this program, and here you are having unconditional branch to this particular location. This is your this memory address 0. Okay, and what you are having at this memory location? At this memory location, you are having the address of the next instruction from where it has left. Okay, so there it has pointed 256. So 256 location, from 256 location it will start executing the program. Okay, so this step you will have before the interrupt, and after interrupt, what is happening? That it is starting from your 256 location and it will start executing it. Okay, so these are actually that is happening in case of your interrupt cycle. Okay, so if there is no any interrupt, your program, main program will be running. If there is interrupt, program counter, it will store the next memory location where the interrupt has taken. It will keep that thing in its memory and it will go to the next location. Okay, so unconditional branch in this location is there. From there, it will run the sub program. And after completion of the sub program, again it will return back and it will continue the remaining program as it is.